City Hall to Congress, Pete Festersen wants a chance and your vote to end the gridlock in D.C.
Well, I think right now people are fed up. They're fed up with Washington and Congress not addressing our nation's challenges, and they're looking for change.
Festersen hopes to succeed where other Democrats failed against Lee Terry. Good evening. I'm Brandi Peterson.
I'm Rob McCartney. His second congressional district seat includes all of Douglas County, urban Sarpy County, including Gretna, La Vista, Papillion. Terry won the seat 15 years ago and has held it ever since.
He may face a challenge in his own party, but so far we're looking at a two-man race. KETV News Watch 7's Adrian Whitsett joins us live with tonight's big story.
Brandi, Pete Festersen says he wants change, thinks that the voters in District 2 want it as well. And after having some second thoughts about not running, he says that he's the man to change Washington.
Well, there's widespread dissatisfaction with Congress and its inability to address our nation's challenges.
A challenge accepted by Pete Festersen. It took some convincing, though. This past August, he told KETV News Watch 7 he could do more locally, staying focused on being a father, business owner, and city council president. Then, the federal government shut down.
Our phone was ringing off the hook with supporters asking us to get involved. We felt it was our responsibility to get involved and help be part of this change, and my family felt the same way. And in fact, my little girls at one point said, "Daddy, you should just do this," and gave me the thumbs up.
Festersen calls himself a moderate Democrat, pro-business and fiscally conservative, ready to take a spirit of compromise to Washington.
We pass budgets, we do pension reform, we renovate our business districts, we do all those things. The federal government should be able to work together, too, to address these challenges. And that's our frustration. They really aren't.
Another Republican, Chip Maxwell, told us last week he's considering a run for Terry's seat. Festersen is the first and so far only Democrat to announce his plans to run in District 2.
But we felt that this was a good juncture to start, given how serious things are out there right now with the shutdown and not addressing our nation's economy and the debt ceiling and spending cuts.
I reached out to Lee Terry Sunday, but he was unavailable for comment. Last week, the Associated Press reported that the congressman has about $560,000 cash on hand, the most he's ever had. Festersen doesn't see that as a problem.
We'll raise enough money to be competitive, and I think people are fed up and ready for a change, and that's what's different about this election cycle.
And Festersen says he's fed up with the way Washington, mostly Congress, can't figure out a way to compromise and fix the nation's problems. He says his work inside City Hall the last 4 years gives him a very good opportunity to go do that here about a year from now. Reporting live, Adrian Whitsett, KETV, News Watch 7.